Hello you guys, welcome back to Double T Friday. In today's video, I'm going to show you how I created the double color exposure effect with Adobe Photoshop. And I'll be using Photoshop CC 2015 to do this. So without any further ado, let's jump right in. To achieve this effect, you need two images with same character but different character style. Bring in these two images to Photoshop and place them in different perspectives. Then the effect begins. But before we start, if you love the videos you see on this channel and it fits your interest, consider subscribing. And don't forget to leave a like on this video and leave a comment if you find this video helpful. So let's begin. For this tutorial, I have six images, two each for different characters with different character styles. And one is for a background image with white background, and the other is for image with a black background, and the other is for an image with no background at all. So I'm going to pick out this image with white background and take it to Photoshop. You can set your size to any size you want to use for Photoshop, but make sure you bring in the two images to Photoshop and activate that, and that is done. So from the two images which you bring to Photoshop, choose one image that will be your main image and the other image will be your subject. So for me, I'm going to use this image as my main image and this is going to be my subject. And the main image must always be at the top layer and the subject should be at the bottom layer. And once you do that, you like to select both image and scale it up like this. Open it up to fill up your canvas. And that's fine. You click on OK and then you set the image in this position just like this, and you're going to hide the top layer so you see the bottom layer, and you click on the bottom layer and bring it here. Then you unhide the top layer and bring it this way. Okay, this is cool. Then you double click here on the top layer to open this up, and you see these layer styles open up, and then you click on your blending options, and where you have to look at is your channel. So you click on R. Remember, RGB stands for red, green and blue. So you are taking off the red channels and this is what we have got. That's fine. You click on OK and then you set your perspective the way you want the pictures to be arranged. Okay, you click on the bottom layer and bring it this way. And this is where I want to place this, and my top layer, I'm going to adjust the size a little. Press Ctrl T to adjust it to transform. You can use Command T if you're using a Mac, and then you place this here. You can adjust again and place here. Okay, this looks fine. Then you click on OK once you are done with that. And the next thing you're going to do is to click on your adjustment layer and click on hue or saturation to activate this. And with this, you can set it to any color you want depending on your choice, but for me, I'm going to leave it at its default color, and that looks okay. And the next thing I'm going to do is to click on my adjustment layer again and click on selective colors. And why I want to do this is to set my colors perfectly and make my colors look okay. So I'm going to select the cyan, which is the color, the blue colors on the image. You adjust the cyan this way, and you can increase the black to make it pop out a little, to add a little depth to the image, and that looks fine. Then you click again and select the reds, and then you can adjust the black to give your image a little depth. You can see how it looks like. It looks perfect, but you have to be careful so you don't make things overdone. Okay, that's fine. Then you adjust your magenta a little. Okay, and your yellows. Okay, this looks cool. Okay, I'm going to leave it at this. And once you're done with this, you're almost done with the effect. Okay, and the next thing I'm going to do is to add adjustment layer again and click on levels to make this image shine up a little. I'm going to adjust it this way, fine, and bring it this way to make it shine a little. And you can adjust the saturation a little and bring this down here a little to get this done. Wow, this is perfect. So for this, we are almost done with the effect, and I need to add a little more effect to give it a little depth that will make this image pop out and better than this. So for that, I'm going to select all the layer, press shift and select all this layer except the background layer, and press Control or Command Alternate E. Okay, so once you do that, it merges all the layers into the first layer, which is here. That is, it makes every layer to become one layer and it merges it here. So with that, the next thing you're going to do is to click on your blending option, selecting the merge layer. You click on Vivid Light, and this is what you get. You click on Filter, click on Other and High Pass, and you get this effect here. Let's zoom in so you see how it looks like. Okay, now you see this effect here, how it looks. Then you're going to adjust your high pass based on how you want this effect to look like. For me, I'm going to leave it at 9.6 pixels. Okay, and that is fine. And this is how the image looks like. It looks pretty good and awesome. So next up, I'm going to add a layer mask on this image and blend off parts of the image I wouldn't like to be visible. So you click on the face layer of the image, or that is our main image, and click here, add layer mask to add a layer mask. And remember, you click here on your foreground color and make sure your foreground is black, and then you click on brush to activate that and brush out the part of this image like this. Now you see there are colors coming up here instead of white. So for that, I'm going to click on the other layer and also add a layer mask as well and brush it also. And when you do this, you are able to close up the whole stuff. Then you're going to brush the area of this image where you don't want it to be visible, just like this. Okay, click on this also and do the same. Click on the layer mask and do the same. So with this, I'm going to bring in my label into the design and let's see how it looks like. Fine. Okay, so this is my label. I'm going to bring it to the top. Okay, and this is how it actually looks like. Okay, so this effect is actually for images with white background. Let's move to the next one, which is images with dark background. Press Ctrl or Command N on your keyboard to create a new document, and then you can make sure that it's actually at international paper and okay. I want to work with A4 size. Okay, then I'm going to bring in my images with dark background, the two image, into Photoshop just like this, and okay. And okay, then you can always scale it or press Ctrl T or Command T on your keyboard to transform and enlarge it like this and fill it up this way. This looks perfect. Okay, you select the other layer, press Ctrl T and adjust it this way as well, and adjust this way, and that's fine. Then you can make this invisible, hide the layer to see how the other layer looks like. Okay, you can bring it to this other side, and this is my main image. Okay, fine. Then you click on this other image and this is our subject. Okay, now the main image should be at the top while the subject should be at the bottom. That's why I've brought this layer to the top. So the next thing you're going to do is to double click on the top layer, and our layer style opens up just like this. And following the same process again, you take off red, and you can choose to take off any color you want depending on what you want to achieve and what you actually want. And you click on OK, and then you can select the subject layer and bring it to this other direction where it's opposite the main image, and that looks fine. And then next thing you want to do is to click on the top layer and click on the adjustment layer and click on hue or saturation. Then you can adjust it to any color that fits what you actually want. For me, I'm going to leave it at this because it actually fits what I want, and that looks fine. You click on your adjustment layer again and click on selective colors, then you activate the cyan. And once you do that, you can make the cyan a little bit pop out like this, and you can adjust the cyan and make it higher a little, and this looks okay. Then you click again and select the reds, and once you do that, you can adjust the reds just like this, or you make it lighter. I'll leave it at -12%, and that looks fine for me. And then you can click again and click on levels to adjust the levels how you actually want it to look like. I'm going to adjust this again to make the blacks even more blacker than that, and adjust this again to this other side to make it shine a little, and this looks perfect. Then you can close the levels adjustment layer just like that. And the next thing you are going to do is to click on this other layer, add a layer mask to brush here like this, and make sure your foreground is at black. Then you can brush this direction like this, and click on this other layer as well and add a layer mask, and then brush here this way. Now you can see the white popping up this way. I'm going to show you how to take that off. You click on your background layer and click on your adjustment layer, and then click on solid color. With that, you can use your color picker tool to select the background color of this image, and then okay. Once you do that, it actually picks that up, and that looks very fine. You select this, and then you can select the layer mask and then brush off the image like this, and this looks perfect. Do the same to this, select the layer mask and brush out this image just like this, and this looks cool. And this is actually what I wanted to achieve. Then I can bring in my label once again, which I made already. You can always do this for your movie poster or any other label you like to use, and then click OK, and this looks perfect. So this is actually how it works for dark images. And the last one I'm going to show to you are images with colored background or any other background apart from white or black. What you're going to do with such image is to take off the background of that image, and you can use any tool, paint tool or your polygonal lasso tool, to take off the background of any image. I've made many tutorials on how to take off or cut out background color of any image, and I'm going to link them down on the description, so you go check that after watching this video. So for that, I'm going to press Ctrl N or Command N on your keyboard if you're using a Mac to open it up again, and set your size to any size you want to work with once again. Then I'm going to bring in the image I want to work with into CorelDRAW. For me, I've taken off the background already, so you can do this for your image with any other color and you want to do this effect. Then you bring it to Photoshop just like this, and it opens up. Then you can still scale this up again just like the other ones we have done. Press Shift and select this, and press Ctrl T to scale up your background just like this. To scale up your image just like this, and okay. And once you do that, you choose the image that needs to be your main image and your subject. For me, I'm going to use this as my main image, and this is going to be my subject. Then I'm going to click on my main image and bring it to the center, and that of my subject, I'm going to bring it to this other direction, and this is how I want my subject to be, and this will be perfect. I think I should still centralize this again, select both image together and move it to the center, and that looks fine. So you select the top layer and double click here to open up your layer style, and once you do that, you take off the red just like all we have done. And you see the effect applies on the image but not on this other face, and that is because there is no background on this image. So what you're going to do is to add a background to each of those images. For that, I'm going to cancel this and then select my top layer. You can select the bottom layer and create a new layer and click here and add solid color. Then you can give it white. Okay, and that looks fine. Then you select, press Shift on your keyboard and select the top layer, right click and click on convert to smart object. Click on the background layer as well, add a new layer, click on your adjustment layer and click on solid color and give it white as well. Press Shift and select this other bottom layer image and right click and click on convert to smart object, and this looks cool. Now you're going to click on your top layer again and double click to open up your layer style, and once you do that, you take off the red, and now you see the effect takes place in the whole image, and this looks perfect. With this, you can click OK and then you are good to go. Next thing you want to do is to click on your adjustment layer and click on selective color, and once you do that, you select the blue or the cyan, and once you do that, you can move this slider here to make the blue color pop out a little and get a little depth and make it darker a little, and this looks perfect. So once that is done, you click this and select the red and adjust the red as well by making it pop out a little, and this looks perfect, cool and nice. You can always adjust these sliders to fit actually what you want, and then you close your selective color layer, click again and open up your levels And once you do that, you can adjust this. Either you adjust the saturation to fit what you actually want, or you can always adjust this to make the colors darker or lighter, and it fits all your choice. Then you close the levels layer, and once you do that, you are good to go. You can always choose to select your hue saturation to change the color to any color you want. I'll leave it here. I perfectly love this color because it brings the blue out better. So I'm going to close this up, and next thing you need to do, it's actually what we have always done. You click on the layer here and add a layer mask. Click on this other layer, also add a layer mask, and then make sure your foreground is black. You click on your brush tool and brush out this layer, and click on this other one and brush this out. Make sure you select the layer mask and brush this out as well. And once you do that, I can bring in my label once again and place on this image, and that looks fine. Okay, you can bring your label to the top, press Ctrl and your square bracket to take it to the top, and this looks okay. So let me know down in the comments if you enjoyed this video and if you've learned something new from this video. Leave a like, leave a comment, and share this video to other graphic designers. This may help someone who is designing a movie poster or wants to make effects like this. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you've not subscribed yet to this channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. And then I'm going to tell you about my channel membership. If you want to get these images I used to make this design, ensure that you join my channel membership. If you check below this video, you will see a place where you see join. Then you click there and join my channel membership to enjoy perks only for channel members. Such perks are design resources and also channel members updates and status. With that, you can always utilize your skills as a graphic designer. Join my channel membership and enjoy my rewards. When you click, you see other rewards attached to it. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'll see you next time.